That's my pencil.
Oh!
Who took the pencil off the floor? Hey, group two! Claire, I mean, who took my pencil off the floor over here? Someone took my pencil off the floor! Let's go, who has it?
Somebody took my pencil off the floor.
No, that's my pencil. Who had the pencil that was on the paper over here on the floor?
Mine broke.
Oh, your arrow is pointing. Your arrow is pointing in that direction. That's north.
Wherever
that arrow is pointing is north. If you are not holding your compass flat, it will not get it correct. Your compass is not flat.
This way.
Okay. Now, if you look around that dial, you will see red markings. If I see the red markings I'm talking about, there's numbers. Those are your degrees. Look at the E on there, that's east. Right beside it is 90 degrees. Your four major coordinates, north, east, south, and west, are on all 90 degree marks. So it's 0 for north, 90 east, 180 is south, and 270 is west. That's the degrees off of north you are. So once you get all the way back around, 360 goes back to 0. All right? If you fold your compass up a little bit, fold your compass. You want to fold it like that, so it makes like an L. Alright? When you do that, you will see an opening in that back panel that has a wire through it. That is your line of sight. Everyone look at the S on this compass through that line of sight. Don't look through that little magnifying glass. It will totally mess your eyes up. It does not work. It is meant for on a map, so we won't be using that. But there is a notch on the top of that little magnet, that magnifying glass. You want to line that little notch up with that wire looking at that S.
I can't see the S from here.
Well, if you sit up. Sit up.
On the wall.
Oh. Oh, that's cool that does that.
It lines up.
The wire gets like really thick through the little part.
Yes, and it should basically cover the S. If you do that again, yes. And this time fold that magnet back down.
You might as well close one eye.
Yes, use your dominant eye. If you're having trouble finding it, use your dominant eye and close the other eye. It might help. Remember your dominant eye from archery. Alright, and if you fold, Bill, hold it up for me. If you, once you find that S in that line of sight, fold that little magnifying glass back down, and you'll notice it pulls up the compass for you, and it holds it in place. All right?
Okay.
Now,
I don't see
the S right here.
It's all right.
still see that?
All right. That's
good.
I'm old.
Would you like to dump or not?
This is also her first day of doing this, I think.
That's right. You weren't here all last week. You know, look, first thing you're going to do is find your S in this right here.
Oh, through here.
Yes.
Okay.
And then once you do that, find it on the notch. You're going to look through this notch all the way through.
Okay.
And
I see so.
Once you find that, as you're looking at the S, fold that down. The magnet. Fold that magnet down. As you're looking at that S. And if you watch, now you can move your compass and look at it straight, and you will see that your compass is not going to move. That little groove that you look through to match up that thing, that little groove lines up with one of those red degree markings. So it tells you exactly what degrees you were looking at. So, let's see. What do you have a little here? Yeah. So you're at 235. So Will, who's sitting right here, is looking at a 235 degree line of sight, all right? So if you're not paying attention, you're going to have a hard time doing our activities later, all right? So now that we have that down, let's talk about how to convert distance into our faces, all right? So if you close up those compasses for me. Magnifying glass down, and then the green part down.
Just this part down.
Yeah.
I'll use some.
Okay. All right. Put it over your magnifier. Sure. This is where your pencil and calculator come into play. On your card, you see where you have your feet and your paces right there, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have your card? You need your card. Everybody's got that written down? and go to the center court. And just move.
No.
You will need a physical. Every day.
Thanks.
Feet into face.
Feet into face.
Feet into mom.
If you didn't write it down, it's going to hurt you on your video. You will need to do this on your video.
Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Paces east.
Fifteen north. Five paces west. Should have been back to your partner. Well, that's why we're practicing there. If we could do it, we wouldn't be doing this. You will need your calculator and a pencil for this one.
Ooh.
and a compass.
Oh, you got a compass? Pencil? I forgot what. We didn't even need it.
Oh, put your compass all the way up. That's the magnifying glass thing.
I was going to say, I know I'm not wrong.
That's going to hold your compass in place. You want it up, Matt. You want it up. Otherwise, your compass won't rotate. All right. The second part, everybody got your compasses open. The magnifying glass is lifted up so that you can move your compass around. All right. Find a 90 degree bearing. That's those red numbers, 90 degrees.
90 degree bearing.
Your partner can help you. This is a teamwork. Your partner can help you.
That's good. That's a good list of stuff.
I do.
The partner is not using the compass right now. Put your forward. Oh, we're not going to do that.
We'll check your email box.
Well, I'm saying that with you. Wait, I do or he does?
You do. If he's the one holding the compass, you put your card down.
Degrees.
Make sure you're holding your compass flat. When you find 225 degrees, go 70 feet.
To go back and try again. That would make a difference. 225.
All right.
that's our car?
45 degrees and go 70 feet.
45 degrees, 70 feet.
Is that 14? I mean,
difference in two different points for that scavenger hunt for two different activities. All right, y'all go.
We're done.
We got your cards. Give your cards back to me.